So the cochlea is part of your hearing organ. It's the part of the, it's the inner ear. It is the piece which actually transduces the sound wave into an electrical signal, which leads to a signal in the auditory nerve, which is your hearing. And so the sound pressure wave comes in, it moves portions of the cochlea, and that motion gets transduced into an electrical signal, which makes it to the auditory nerve. So the cochlea is in all animals, at least all mammals for certain, is buried behind the densest bone in the body. And so in humans, that's a couple of centimeters of bone to get through. So it's very difficult, obviously, to get through that bone to do imaging. In the mouse where we've been working, it's about a couple hundred microns thick of dense bone. So you have to be able to see through that in order to measure the soft tissues on the inside, which is what you want to measure to understand the mechanics of the ear. So the challenge is getting past that bone and measuring the vibrations. And on top of that, the vibrations are very small, the order of a nanometer in scale. So the very small vibrations buried behind a very strongly scattering dense bone. What we're using is a technology based on optical coherence tomography, which is currently used clinically to image in the eye and also to do intravascular imaging for measuring atherosclerosis. What we're doing is applying that to imaging in the ear. Specifically, it can image through the bone of the ear and is able to measure very small scale vibrations by looking at the interferometric phase. And so it can have a phase sensitivity or a motion sensitivity on the order of tens to hundreds of picometers. And so that lets us make these kind of really fine, very precise measurements of the mouse cochlea. And so we make these measurements at the same time as we're playing sounds. And by doing that, we can measure out the function of the ear. And then we can look at different pathologies, different diseases in the mouse, different genetic mutations, and try to understand how those things change the mechanics and morphology of the ear. Okay, so first of all, we're generating some of the very first mechanical or functional measurements across all the soft tissues, the organ accordion, which is part of the inner ear. And so before that, there was no detailed vibrational measurements of the entire organ inside an unopened cochlea. By unopened, that means the bone is not opened up. So that first is the first thing we're measuring. In addition, one of the things we have found is that the mammalian cochlea, which is fairly standard across all mammals, there's two unique things, or at least two unique things for mammalian hearing. And that is, it has gain. In other words, there's some process in it which produce movement. And there's also the narrowing of the frequency bandwidth, which gives you sort of a narrow band of hearing. And previously, those things have been thought to be strongly related. But what we found by making the measurements inside the organ of Corti is that the narrowing of the frequency band and the gain happen in sort of two different areas. And where the gain is part of the active processes, the narrowing of the frequency band is more part of the passive mechanics or passive processes of the ear. One of the challenges with the ear is that it's buried deep inside bone, and so it's hard to get good measurements on it, and especially because it's a functional thing, so it moves. And part of the movement is part of its function. And so there's not a lot of information available for functioning of even a healthy cochlea, and so let alone pathology or diseases. And so before we can come up with cures or therapies for hearing loss, we really need to understand in detail how it works, both in a healthy cochlea as well as in a diseased cochlea. That's just an essential part of trying to figure out how to develop the right kind of therapies.